Hey, how's it going, everyone? I'm going to be taking a look at the next 8 days of astrology from July 20 through July 28 of 2020. I have the aspect list up here on the screen, which you can find written out in the description of this video that you can reference throughout the week as usual. So we have a new moon, a Cancer new moon here on Monday morning, starting a fresh new cycle to work with. We're also going to have both the moon and the sun form an opposition to Saturn with that new moon, and quincunx, also known as the in conjunct to the south node in Sagittarius. And then we're going to have a change of season as the sun will ingress Leo, a change of focus, change of energy there. Mercury will sextile Uranus. We're going to have a lot of lunar aspects throughout the week. And it looks like by next Monday is the most dynamic day out of this forecast. July 27, we're going to have the first quarter moon. Moon square sun. Jupiter comes back into another sextile with Neptune. Venus has to make an in conjunction, the quincunx to Jupiter. Venus makes the third and final square to Neptune. And Mercury is opposing Mars. And finally, on that day, the end of that day, the moon opposes Uranus. So it's definitely a very dynamic day. Will be interesting to see what plays out with all these different aspects. So those are the main aspects. Let's take a look at the new moon chart that we start this week off with. We're going to have this new moon exact at 28 degrees, 26 minutes of Cancer at 10:32 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time. So find out California time and your local time, do the difference in the math, and you'll know when it is for you. So this pretty much sets the tone for the next lunar cycle that we have here. And we've had two cycles within Cancer. The first one was a solar eclipse at 0 degrees of Cancer. And now this one is at the end of Cancer, which I consider to be, you know, a new moon at the last degrees is like a new beginning, or the beginning of the end, in a sense, in regards to everything Cancerian that's been playing out, especially in regards to the last few years with the North Node in Cancer trying to get us on that path. And this is a chance to plant some roots and some seeds around this Cancerian area of life that can have an effect for your future. So basically, this is setting up the next 6 months, and all this eclipse energy that we just went through this last month, all this stuff has kind of like a six-month cycle. So we're going to see the results of all these changes and these new beginnings in certain areas of our life at the end of the year, into the new year. So this is about planting seeds for everything Cancerian. But there's a major opposition with this new moon, and that is exactly opposite Saturn and exactly quincunx, the south node in Sagittarius. So the moon is strong in Cancer. It's at its home. It's powerful. And yet Saturn is also strong and powerful in Capricorn. So this is an opposition between the inner and the outer world, generally speaking here. And then find in your birth chart where you have Cancer. And that's where there's a new beginning that you can work with, new energy that you can work with, definitely over this next month. But then, like I said, you'll be still developing that area for the next 6 months, basically the rest of the year. So, you know, the moon in Cancer with the sun, this new moon in Cancer, this opposition that's playing out between the inner and the outer world, safety and security and comfort, what we want, emotion, safety around what feels comfortable to be in. And yet there's a major tough opposition playing out in the outer world with authorities. And then on personal levels, it can also be like there's an opposition between the light and the mood. So an opposition between what you want to do, what your feelings are calling for, how to take care of yourself, how to nurture yourself and your family, how to protect what's yours and your loved ones and your property, your inner world. What do you need right now to feel good and to feel okay? Well, that whatever that need is that you should be coming into awareness about through this process is being opposed by something tougher, something hard, something more, something that challenges your needs right now. And that can play out through perhaps wanting to do what you want to do to feel good, and yet you have maybe responsibilities, a commitment, duty, obligations, stuff that you just have to take care of whether you want to or not. That could be part of that, especially if you have planets around these cardinal degrees, the last few degrees of the cardinal signs, Aries, Cancer, Libra, and Capricorn, definitely going to impact you. And always remember that when I look at these transits out in the world, it's the outer framework. It's kind of like the background energy that's playing out for the world. But your personal transits are always going to be the most important for you. So there could be some hard energy out in the world generally. There could be some easy days out there. But you might have a tough transit. And you're going to be going through your own personal situation regardless of what's going on in the sky for everybody. So just keep that in mind. You have to really know your birth chart and apply this to your chart. But this is the background energy. This is the mundane context of it all. And, you know, this is going to create this opposition on the safety, security axis. We've already been dealing with this opposition over and over and over again through many different cycles this past couple of years. And this is kind of like the final one here for the next 6 months that can finalize this restructuring process that's going on in your Capricorn area of life. And in the mundane context, it's the government, the world, changes, power and control issues out there in the world, intensity, things like, you know, what we're seeing play out this year in 2020, that's kind of messy. All that stuff out there is changing. The systems are changing, laws and rules are changing, the structures of society is changing. And we may not see all those changes right now in our vision, but in hindsight, we will see that this time frame of the world is creating changes. Now, the fact that Saturn is opposing that moon energy, that's what I'm saying as far as the opposition to what you want versus what you have to do, what you have to take care of, what you're forced to look at. And so there can be something uncomfortable here. There can be weight, there can be burden, feeling of duty and responsibility that just doesn't feel easy for you to do. And you have to find that balance. How can you take good care of yourself? How can you nurture yourself? How can you feel safe, be in your environment that feels good to you, and yet still maintain responsibility and take care of what you have to take care of in life? You know, still step up to the plate, be mature and responsible, still have integrity and discipline, and do what needs to be done despite how you feel about it. And yet it can't be totally on that other side of Capricorn and just work and responsibility and all that stuff either. You have to find that middle ground between, you know, your inner and your outer life there and what feels good. But it's not always going to feel good. That's the point. And then the sun being wrapped up into this, the sun is the vitality. The sun is the ego, your focus, your what we're focusing on right now. There could be a major opposition to that where you could feel down, you could feel insecurities coming up, or there could be oppositions within relationships where other people are trying to dim your light, not wanting you to feel good, not wanting you to shine bright. And you could, that could be through other people, or it could even be through yourself and how you're feeling about things in yourself right now. So there's like a criticalness with this energy, with Saturn in opposition, and it's really opposite Pluto and Jupiter at the same time, but it's perfectly opposite Saturn. So there can be a sense of people being overly critical, or you could be critical with yourself or other people. You have to be careful of that dynamic. Don't let people take you down. People might be very judgmental in this cycle that we're building into with the opposition to Saturn. So be careful of your own judgments as well, which kind of goes into this aspect of the quincunx to the south node in Sagittarius. You know, opinions and beliefs being very strong and having to make adjustments in this new cycle to some of those judgments, how we look at the world, culture issues. And of course, that south node in Sagittarius is ruled by Jupiter conjunct Pluto. And so these things are extra powerful, extra extreme and radical and intense, and going through a big transformation process. And we see that through events out in the world playing out. And you may have similar power struggles and those power themes within your personal chart wherever you have Capricorn that we have to make major adjustments to in this lunar cycle. So it is going to amp up the criticism, the judgment, the righteousness, the extremes of beliefs and opinions, culture issues, and everything getting really powerfully intensified, not only because of these alignments, but also because Mars in Aries is building up pressure, building up that tension, and it'll finally reach a peak as we get later into August into September, and will kind of continue for the rest of the year. So there's a lot of tension building up, and there's a lot of cardinal energy. This new moon is in a cardinal sign, which is about starting something, initiating something, and generally it's about Cancer, the home, borders, walls, being protective of what's yours, what you love, your where you come from, family. And it could be also a final planting of seeds in regards to home life issues, real estate, property, moving, getting settled, things like that. And yet there's an opposition to that that you may have to face. You know, what's blocking you? What are the obstacles? Because there could be obstacles and things that just don't make this process easy of trying to develop in a kind of like a final way, the safety, security, and the comfort of your inner world and your home and family dynamics that are trying to change this past 2 years. And hopefully you've developed a lot of that already, and this is just the final stretch of that. That's pretty much the dynamic. Saturn can kind of dim the light, though. Just know that it can be kind of a depressive, heavy burden, kind of a sober type of new energy that we're moving into. And because it is at the last degrees, it is the beginning of the end of this process of these Cancer developments. We're going to have Mercury follow up behind that. We're still thinking a lot about all this. And then we're going to have Venus come into Cancer. So we're still going to have some Cancerian dynamics even after we have this change of season. But this is the main theme of the finalization of beginning to end this process for changes in your inner world, home life, family dynamics. And then on the world stage, the safety and security axis with nations and borders and laws and regulations to keep people safe is what they kind of frame it in. So it can be kind of heavy with this opposition. There's no doubt about it. And that's pretty much the main aspects to this new moon. Energy levels can be a little drained sometimes with this opposition, feeling tired, emotional, sensitive. Of course, it is Cancer. It can be a little more, not as tender though. It's not going to be as tender because of that opposition to Saturn, which creates that need to be protective of the sensitivities. And then this fierce energy of Mars, very strong in Aries, building up this momentum for conflict. It could be, you know, this beginning of a war type energy that's building up. We could probably see this start to play out in a lot of conflicts in the world, maybe military conflicts eventually by the end of August into September and beyond, and then in personal relationships, and then on the streets with protests. There's still this energy that's trying to create individuality and freedom and a little bit of rebelliousness and clashing with the Capricorn side, the rules, the laws, the government, what's outside of our power and our control that we kind of have to accept on some levels. We don't have full control. And if you think you do have full control, it's an illusion. Because if you're going to bump up into a brick wall or authorities or things that you just don't have complete control over, and you have to kind of accept that, adapt to that, make adjustments based on what's going on in your public life, in the world, or in your personal house of Capricorn. But there's this fierce Mars energy that's going to kind of push the limits, push the boundaries. It's not quite totally activated yet this week, though. It's going to take some time. In the next couple weeks or so, it's going to get stronger and stronger. But it's still, we have all this cardinal energy. It's still about action. It's still about initiation and doing something, taking action on something that might not feel easy or might be hard, delayed, restricted, limited in some way. So your comfort, your safety, or what you want could be limited in some way. And there could be an element of the unknown still a little bit that you might have to adjust to later on that you're not quite certain about right now. So that's pretty much what I can say about all that. Let's move this forward through the week. We start this with a brand new energy. The moon will be waxing forward through this entire next 8 days, waxing through Leo, Virgo, Libra, and by next Tuesday, Scorpio. Building energy, building light, building something new with momentum forward. Mercury is moving forward from its retrograde here. Venus is building that final square with Neptune. So we're going to have this Venus-Neptune square really strong, I think, most of this week, even before it's exact. By next Monday, it's still within orb. It's already within 5-degree orb, so every day it gets stronger and stronger, which is going to affect relationships, especially by the time that the moon reaches Libra. We'll talk about that, but let's move this forward here. Right off the bat, right after that new moon in the morning, there's a big change of energy as the moon enters Leo and a change of the dynamics. Because the moon rules Cancer. So even though the sun is at the last 2 degrees of Cancer here, the dynamics really do change on Monday afternoon as the moon enters Leo and it becomes a little more dramatic, a little more expressive, something a little more the need to be expressive, the need to get your feelings out there. But it's still in that new moon energy. The moon is dark. There's no light on it. So it's still about planting seeds of intentions for your, you know, home life scenarios or your family dynamics, and you can build that up through Leo and just be a little more creative and passionate about those things. The moon in Leo is going to be wanting to feel some sort of fun and joy and happiness, and yet it's kind of opposed by Saturn still. Even as it enters Leo, it's still in opposition to Saturn, and we can't quite get everything we want, or we can't do everything that we want to do, but there's still a need to express, create, have some fun, feel passionate, joyful, get in touch with your heart. What is your heart calling for? And especially in regards to home and family dynamics or living situations, and all that type of stuff. But because Uranus is in Taurus, the moon is building up to that square, and it just adds kind of a disruptive energy that could be very strong within the first couple days of this cycle. One second here. So the rest of the day, however, the sun will be perfecting the opposition with Saturn and the in conjunction to the south node. So that new moon energy, the theme of it that I was just talking about, will pretty much last all through Monday. And it can feel heavy. It can be critical. It can be a little bit dramatic with that criticism from other people trying to dim your light, or the judgments coming at you could be possible, or your own sense of judgment with yourself and other people, or your family dynamic, or your public life, or the world. Just kind of heavy. And like I said, just remember that opposition to the inner and the outer. You can't do just one or the other. You can't just totally retreat, hide away in your shell, cover your head with the blanket, and just ignore everything. That will add more stress, more pressure, and it just won't be the best use of it. You have to find that balance somehow between your responsibilities, your commitments, your what you're obligated to do, what's outside of your control that you have to take care of. And then try to find those downtimes, those times where you can retreat inward, relax, nurture yourself, take good care of yourself, whatever it takes to feel good. You have to find that happy balance on Monday. At least that's the best use of it. You can do whatever you want. The moon will be waxing through Leo all day. And then by Tuesday, July 21st, the moon, first thing in the morning, the moon is square Uranus, which just adds some level of disruption, most likely. The normal flow of the day can have some disruptions, pretty much, or some unexpected scenarios. The mood could change, could be a little bit dramatic. And there's this conflict between Taurus and Leo. Leo wants to have fun, express, be connected to the heart, and very passionate and fiery and wanting to do something. And yet Taurus is kind of fixed energy, wanting to keep things simple, calm, slow things down. So there's this tug of war between these two signs. And then Uranus, something has to be different. And the emotions, the feelings aren't on board with being innovative and trying new things and doing things that are different than how you may have done things in the past. And because the moon rules Cancer, where the sun is at the last degree, this sense of urgency to finalize something around this home and family, domestic life, the inner world scenarios, it's connecting to Uranus, of looking at it in a different way, trying new things, trying new solutions that you maybe wouldn't have tried before, but that process has a lot of tension in it. But maybe whatever sparks up in the circumstances or the mood on Tuesday morning, and then Mercury can follow up with the sextile to Uranus after that and work with it a bit different. So right after that tension with Uranus, which kind of like sets the tone for the day is not going to be normal. Don't set like a solid plan on Tuesday, July 21st. Be open to adjustments or things changing, change of plans. That way you're not caught off guard. But then right after that dynamic, the moon in Leo is trine Mars in Aries and building the sextile to Venus. And there's an open outlet to take positive action. Mars is direct in a very fiery, passionate, brave, impulsive sign of Aries, independent. And the moon in Leo, building light, forward progress. There's an opportunity to get something done here, to take appropriate action on Tuesday morning. And then also just have this connection to be very fiery and passionate and moving into something. More courage, more bravery. As we go through the day on Tuesday, that's pretty much the biggest theme. And then the moon does sextile over to Venus Tuesday evening, which is a few hours of an opportunity to feel good about something, to indulge in something pleasurable, and in this case, something creative through communications, perhaps, connecting to relationships, other people, a network, information, and there's just a good opportunity here to feel satisfied, content, pleasured in what you're doing through communications and creativity. It could be social, it could be recreation there for a little bit on Tuesday evening. That works out nicely. But the sun is at the last few minutes of Cancer. So this strong sense of something ending on Monday into Tuesday, something is ready to change here. The moon moves forward and then has to make an in conjunction to both Jupiter and Neptune to close out the night, which pretty much is the overnight hours into Wednesday morning, July 22nd. The mood has to make a lot of adjustments here between different influences, things that are kind of unconscious, the blind spot, the collective mood, Jupiter in the world with laws, culture issues, beliefs, opinions. And so it's kind of like a dynamic mood that you have to make a lot of adjustments, basically, for a few hours there on Wednesday morning. But most people are sleeping at this time, so it may not be anything major, or you could have kind of a rough sleep and trying to get to sleep or something. It could be kind of picking up on a lot of different things that your mind could be spinning or something like that. And as we go deeper into Wednesday, July 22nd, the sun ingresses Leo. Big change of energy, big change of focus, change of season here. And the sun is at home. So it's like the king and the queen have returned home to where they're, to where they feel good, where they're able to express this Leo energy. So now we have both the sun and the moon in Leo here in a building cycle. And this adds a lot more passion, kind of a lot more opportunity to leave some of the more intense emotions behind a little bit. We still have some of that because of Mercury there in Cancer. Our mind is still thinking about our feelings and needs and safety issues and what we want and all that stuff. But the sun is now more powerful. Energy levels could start to increase from this point on because now we have more fire energy, three planets in fire, and the sun is, you know, slowly going to be moving away from the opposition to Saturn, which may have drained the vitality a little bit. And so now we can start building up into something new and different here, focusing on the heart, passion, creativity, leadership, joy, and trying to focus on what feels good at this time. What can we do to make things better and still have to adjust, however, to what's outside of our control, to the world, to the laws, regulations, our responsibilities and all that. But it's a much more fiery, passionate, creative new energy that we're coming into at this point. And that's only increased by the fact that Mars is in Aries too. It's a lot more fire, a lot more need to take action and move forward to be decisive and make decisions in a way that you feel confident about. So this can also help the confidence that maybe was going through some difficulties this past week with the opposition to Saturn. But it's, you know, it's not going to just right away happen instantly. It's going to take time to build this up. Let's see here. The moon still has to go through more in conjunctions on Wednesday, which, you know, puts a damper on the light and the joy and the happiness and the fun and the creativity a little bit, because we have to make adjustments to what's going on out here in the world. The moon, as it's moving through the last part of Leo here, it's in conjunct Pluto and Saturn on Wednesday, all day on Wednesday. And so there's power struggles that we have to adapt to, or the world stuff, the laws, all that stuff that I was just explaining, that can kind of, you know, take a little bit of that good Leo energy away a little bit. But it's still way better energy than what we were experiencing before. And here's Mercury building up to that perfect sextile with Uranus. Is that going to be on Wednesday? Yes, Wednesday afternoon, July 22nd, when the moon is at the last degrees of Leo. The moon makes a connection to the south node and the north node of destiny. So things are starting to change. Something new, it's a new vibe, a new energy is coming in. We get the sense that something is changing here, and it's connected to destiny, and it's in a positive way. But we're also having to make adjustments and connections and of what's going on here on Wednesday afternoon based on the past, based on culture, based on the world and what's going on out there, or in your personal Sagittarius area of life. There's things that you're picking up on from that area that are ending, that are changing, that are no longer 100% fulfilling you. And that can be a little bit of an issue here, is that the moon in Leo wants to feel good and have a good time and express and feel joy and happiness, be creative, and yet it's connecting to the south node in a very easy way, which doesn't always offer that feeling of contentment and being satisfied in that moment. And that's where you're adjusting to Saturn too, of those pressures, the stress, the judgments, the work, the responsibilities, the laws, the regulations, restrictions, limitations, and the karma that's playing out. But right after that, we have Mercury making the perfect sextile to Uranus on Wednesday afternoon. And so it's from the Cancer Taurus area. And Mercury went through here already. And now this is the direct pass, the final sextile to Uranus, which is about, okay, after Mercury retrograde and reevaluating some of these domestic issues, your safety, security concerns, your home and family concerns, where you live, borders, your nation, whatever it is for you, it's about now you have this final kind of connection to looking at Uranus in a way where you can work with it. How can you do this home and family situation where we just planted seeds in a way that's innovative and different from the past, where you can work with this Uranus Taurus, a change of values in regards to your home, family, living situation, or what you need to feel good, and how you nurture yourself, how you take care of yourself, all that stuff. It's about looking at it through a different perspective. And we've had the chance to kind of go back and forth with that the last month and evaluate some of those possibilities. And now we're getting another chance to really look at it through a better perspective after the Mercury retrograde is moving forward now. But we still have that Mercury-Mars tension, and that's going to be building up too, another round of that through this forecast. So there's still that communication tension. People are passionate and fiery, sensitive. You could, you know, there could be arguments, mechanical breakdowns could be building up again, or traveling issues where you have to check your car, or feeling rushed, like you have to do something. But I think that, you know, at least on Wednesday afternoon, when Mercury is connecting to Uranus, there's a great opportunity to look at your home, family, and your inner world differently from before, and then be willing to innovate in those new ways that you're looking at with possibilities. So right after that, the moon will ingress Virgo, and another change of mood here, another change of circumstances on Wednesday night. The moon in Virgo, now it's about, let's start working on something. Let's start getting practical about these changes. Let's start making improvements. Let's get organized and detailed and figure it all out and do something that's more productive. And now that the moon is in Virgo, it's going to be a very productive 2.5 days after this. So Wednesday night into Thursday and Friday, especially Friday, can be very productive with the moon in Virgo, making good aspects to Uranus and the Capricorn transits. There'll be some distractions and some adjustments in that process, but overall, it's really a time, you know, to get practical at this point, and analytical and detailed, and clean up. It's time to clean up, get things in order. There's a need to be of service and be productive, and all that as the moon enters Virgo. There's a need for purification. So this is a great time to put in the work to make improvements happen. And that sets the tone for the next few days. And then as we get to Thursday, July 23rd, the moon is in the beginning of Virgo, building the trine to Uranus and the sextile to Mercury. So the first part of the day is going to be better than the second half of Thursday. First part of the day, the moon reaches that trine to Uranus and the sextile to Mercury. So again, moon in Virgo, about improvements, organization, cleaning up, being of service, working, being productive. And we have an open outlet to Uranus and Taurus of making innovative changes that could just easily happen. Being more willing, being more comfortable with creating changes in your everyday routine or what you're trying to improve or be productive with on Thursday morning. And then with Mercury sextile over to Mercury, moon to Mercury, there's a mutual reception here because the moon is in Mercury's sign and Mercury's in the moon sign. So this is a really great aspect on the first half of Thursday. Moon Mercury, the ability to communicate, get your feelings across, understand your own feelings, being logical and practical about those things, and not just overly emotional, and yet factoring in feelings and emotions at the same time. So a good little balance there of being both practical and sensitive about what you're working on and being able to look at things differently and innovatively and, you know, being productive with what you're doing. So it's a good day to run errands, good day to communicate, publish anything, write, speak, broadcast, edit, anything like that. It's a great time for. But then in, later in the day, as the moon moves through that alignment, as we get to Thursday evening, the moon has to make the in conjunction to Mars and then square over to Venus. And so having to make adjustments to Mars and Aries, Mars being impulsive, wanting to rush into something, wanting to be fiery, passionate, brave, courageous, a little bit agitated or aggressive in what you're doing. And the moon has to make adjustments to that desire for that type of stuff and say, whoa, let's slow things down. Let's be a little more practical and cautious about these things. Let's look at what's most important and not just jump headfirst into something. So again, making adjustments between the desire to move quickly with something. And then right after that, the moon on Thursday night squaring over to Venus right before it makes the opposition to Neptune. So kind of building this T-square between moon, Neptune, and Venus, which will really spark that, activate that Venus square Neptune really strongly right after that. There's distractions all of a sudden. Now it's hard to narrow it all down. Venus in Gemini is all about duality. It's about information here, wanting a variety of different stimulation and communicating or news and information. There's a lot coming out. And the moon is like in a hard aspect to all that. What Venus is attracted to, so what we desire, what we're attracted to on Thursday night, the moon is not on board with that. The moon is trying to say, let's narrow it down. Let's not just have it all scattered and be into all these different things. Venus could also be very changeable. So our desires, feminine energy, relationships could be a little bit challenged on Thursday night. There could also be this challenge of trying to find that sweet spot, trying to feel satisfied and content. It's hard to do because the moon is trying to get practical, narrow it all down, be more precise, be of help in some way or working on something. And Venus is a little more fickle in that spot or taking on too much, or there's just distractions, things that we could be attracted to, things that we desire could be distracting us away from being practical and kind of grounded about the subject in some way there. So it could just be a little bit of a clash in the mood and the feelings and the desires. The thing that will emotionally nurture you, which is Virgo traits, is not what will turn you on, Venus and Gemini. And the things that turn you on that you're attracted to on Thursday night, Venus and Gemini, isn't what's going to nurture you. So it's a hard aspect to try to feel good. And people could be trying many different ways, many different things to try to hit that sweet spot and feel content and satisfied and pleasured with whatever you're into on that night. And it may be difficult to do that. And then right after that, the moon is opposing Neptune, which has even more distractions. And there's an opposition here, which could play out through relationships, since the moon is activating Venus in a hard way, where one person could be overly sensitive, very inspired and dreamy and all into this magical mood, romantic mood in some way. And then another person could be a little more critical, a little more grounded about it, a little more standoffish, less emotional about it. And it could create some tension in the dynamics with relationships or your own mood on Friday. And then there's this opposition trying to pull you into things that are, you know, other realities and things that are distracting you, like movies or film or books or whatever, you know, something pulling you away from what's practical. And you have to find that happy balance, or you can just wait it out and the aspect will pass if you give it time, because it doesn't last very long. But it does spark up that Venus-Neptune, which will be coming exact by next Monday. And it's already at play here, which is, again, we've already had two squares of Venus. So this entire Venus process in Gemini from April through July is about trying to figure out what we want, what we desire, and what we value in regards to Gemini. So you have to apply that to wherever you have Gemini in your chart. That's where you've been trying to figure out what you value in that area, what's important for you there that can give you some level of pleasure or opportunity, a project. And in Gemini, you know, communications, information, a network, your local environment, learning something new. But it's different for everybody based on your personal chart. And so there's been a little bit of confusion about what that is. What do we want in that area? Because of the squares to Neptune. And there's been a lot of fantasy, a lot of idealistic romanticizing of a situation, a lot of like burying your head in the sand, not wanting to look at what's tough, and just kind of going into your own little world of fantasy. So some illusions that have to kind of go through a process. And we've already been going back and forth with some of those illusions. And now we have to reach the final conclusion around those delusions or those fantasies or some of our desires, or trying to figure out what it is that we truly value and desire and want in your area of life that is ruled by Gemini. So romance is going to kind of build up from this point again. People getting a little romantic, dreamy, this need for magic, this need for spirituality, art, music, creativity, wanting to have your own little world of that magic despite what's going on out in the world or your own stresses and pressures that you have to deal with. There's a need for escapism. So drugs, alcohol becomes another round of desire for people generally. So the high side is knowing that you may not be 100% clear in your values or your desires this week, and not jumping headfirst into something that could turn out negative later on. So keeping your expectations in check is a good way of working with this square, because people are going to expect a relationship or a project or a situation to be a certain way. And then when it doesn't turn out to be exactly that situation, that leads to disappointment, disillusionment, and a lack of fulfillment in that way. So keeping your expectations low, not falling in for a trap, being careful of money issues this week as well. Since Venus does rule Taurus, financial issues, there could be something shady. You got to be careful of buying something of value, something, a big ticket item. If you don't have to, hold off for a week or so. I would hold off until August. I've been saying this for a while, until you're clear, because Venus has to get through that square with Neptune, which the moon is kind of activating on Thursday night. So, you know, hold off on thinking that you know what you want right now. And maybe there's a lot more clarity than the last couple of months. You know, there's, and that should be the case. We should be coming closer and closer to understanding what we truly desire and want in our area of life that is ruled by Gemini. But we're not 100% there just yet based on the astrology until Venus gets past that square with Neptune for a third and final time. So be careful of relationships, of falling head over heels for someone or a situation. Basically, be careful of a desire in regards to a person, place, or thing. And just hold off, reflect on it. You know, take time to see how you feel about that maybe next week and beyond before making a big decision about that. All right, with that said, let's move on here. So as we get into Friday, July 24, the moon is at the last part of Virgo, making trines to Jupiter, Pluto, and Saturn. And this will be by far the most productive day out of the week. So Friday, get things done, get practical. There's this easy energy to make improvements, go through a transformation that's very practical and realistic and grounded. Take care of business, work, you know, purification, clean up. So there's a great outlet between your Virgo area of life and your Capricorn area of life on Friday, where you can work with the energy a lot better. You can work with what's going on out in the world a lot better. You can feel more comfortable about what's going on in your outer life or your Capricorn area of life. You can feel more powerful. So by working, by making improvements, by doing something productive, it can add a sense of power and help you feel emotionally satisfied. And then there's just this open outlet to be more mature, to be more disciplined and reliable and, again, productive. So take care of business on Friday. Especially the first half of the day is going to be the best part. Let's see here. The second or Friday evening will be much different than the first part of the day. So yeah, take care of what needs to be done the first half of the day, all the way up to 4 o'clock Pacific time. So most of Friday for the world will be really positive, productive energy. And then after that, the moon will reach the midpoint to the nodes of fate and T-square the nodes of fate by Friday evening. And we're at this crossroads. And something wants to end, something wants to change. And there's about to be a new dynamic, a new mood and circumstances. So we could be at this crossroads emotionally or with circumstances or what we've done productively through Friday. It could have us making a long-lasting change in some way. But just know that fate is at play by Friday night. And then the moon will ingress Libra, and there's going to be a big change of energy there. Another mood change. And now the moon in Libra, it's air energy, which is ruled by Venus down here in Gemini. So Venus becomes a stronger player, and that just so happens to be as Venus is coming into that exact square with Neptune through the weekend into Monday. So now with the moon in Libra, there's a need for intellectual emotional energy, not getting sucked up into the emotions of the moment, but stepping back, being objective about it, being intellectual about feelings and the mood and all that. And also it's time to start weighing things out, Libra, you know, starting to look at things differently, objectively, and weighing out what needs to balance out in your life. And then, of course, anytime the moon is moving through Libra, it puts more emphasis on relationships. So wanting to be more diplomatic, graceful, accommodating, more peaceful, and trying to find harmony within social situations and relationships. And there's a strong emotional need here at this point to put focus on relationships and social energy and reach out to other people. And then also an emotional need for beauty, creating beauty in all of its different forms, music, art, just making things more pleasant. There's going to be some complications in that process later on, but in the first part of it, it should work out pretty nicely, because on Friday night, the moon in Libra will sextile the sun right before we leave Friday into the weekend there. So you can be, the sun and moon making a positive connection. It's just, it makes the energy flow more easily, more cooperation with other people. Just your own mood, your feelings are kind of in sync with what you're focused on. The need for fun and creativity and joy and happiness and being heartfelt and creative. All that energy is connected to relationships and art and beauty. And then because Venus rules that moon phase, and Venus is square Neptune, it adds a lot more sensitivity than the typical Libra moon. So this is going to be romanticizing energy, much more romantic, but not necessarily realistic. And this is where you have to be cautious. A lot more of a need for art and music and being creative and tapping into something that's taking you away from something that's out in the world or hard. So, you know, the best use of it would be using it for creativity and art and music and getting into something, you know, that inspires you and just remaining grounded in that process the best you can. And know this aspect that not everything is grounded or realistic in this process with other people or what you desire. So the negative side, people will definitely want to start, taking the edge off through escapism tendencies in negative ways. A lot of drinking and drug use and video games, movies, just other realities, avoiding things, burying your head in the sand, dreaming and fantasizing. All that stuff becomes super strong at this point. As we get into Saturday, July 25, let me look at my list here. Moon in conjunct Uranus, Moon square Mercury, Moon op Mars. There's some tension here on Saturday. It's actually more tension than ease. So Friday was probably one of the better days. And then Saturday, we start to build up some emotional tension in regards to trying to keep the peace, trying to find that beauty and that harmony, trying to be accommodating, trying to balance out things, being objective about it. But we have to make some adjustments here to Uranus. You know, be willing to not have a set plan on Saturday. There could be disruptions or could be adjustments that have to be made to those plans or something like that. Also, the moon in Libra is building up to this cardinal T-square with Mercury and Mars, which really activates the Mercury square Mars aspect again. It's already been in play, but it's coming for another round here of aggressiveness through communication, feeling rushed, wanting to take action on something. So let's move that into play here by Saturday afternoon. The moon square Mercury, Saturday evening, Saturday night, pretty much. So this is not the day, and it's kind of a grand cross. The moon will be forming this grand cross. It's not exact, it's not perfect, and it doesn't last very long, just a couple days here with the moon moving through Libra. So this is where the balance is definitely challenged, the harmony is challenged, the peace is challenged, and that's because there's three different areas we're being pulled into. The Cancer, the Libra, well, four areas if you consider it a grand cross. Four different areas that the moon is picking up on. The moon has to factor in relationships. It has to factor in other people. We have to make decisions. Our mood is influenced by other people. And then all these other things. Our mood is influenced by relationships, trying to be, you know, peaceful and diplomatic. And then we're having a mood and our own feelings about things, our family dynamic, our need for safety and security is being factored in here. We're thinking about those things. And then Mars in the opposite sign of Aries, the need to be impulsive and take action and initiate something, do something, be independent and free, thinking about ourselves and what we desire, what we want to do, regardless of all these other factors. And yet we can't just do that. We have too many other influences pulling on us that is causing some challenge here. And then, of course, the square to Capricorn, our limitations, our restrictions, what we are responsible for, what we have to do, what we're obligated to do. So it's like a strong emotional dynamic of trying to find that balance between all these different things that are pulling on us that's coming up here on Saturday night. And strong emotional energy. It's hard to communicate. We're trying to communicate peacefully. We want to be peaceful. Our emotional need is to be peaceful and think about other people. But Mercury in Cancer, there's some blocks. There's some need to pull back and be more protective. And so people could be communicating very strongly. They could be acting out aggressively, speaking aggressively, kind of this conflict energy in communications, and people being overly protective, overly sensitive about things. And, you know, feeling attacked because of Mars in the picture here. So it's a very dynamic, powerful few hours there on Saturday night that looks complicated. This could be playing out through protest or, you know, I don't know if we should call it protest, more like rioting perhaps and violence out in the world and on the streets. There could be something around that that's really being strongly activated, most likely Saturday night, July 25, and for the rest of the weekend for that matter. And yet people are kind of still in their dreamland here because it's all ruled by Venus square Neptune. Are they overlooking something? Are they not being realistic about something? Or are they kind of in their own illusional, delusional idea and kind of fighting for something, even if it's not exactly realistic or true? Something like that could be the case. I would be careful of drunk drivers this weekend. This could lead to people, you know, trying to take the edge off, and then there could be accidents or transportation issues, communication issues, electronic issues, mechanical breakdowns from this point forward are very strong. Of course, not for everybody, but you have to be just be aware of that possibility and double check things. Just be more conscious. Keep your feet on the ground and try not to get lost in illusions or fantasies about a certain situation. So there's so much dynamic here through the weekend into Monday that it's complicated. There's so much going on. But the peace is having a challenging time there with the moon in Libra. And then as we get to Sunday, July 26, right off the bat, the moon makes a nice trine to Venus, but that's like super early in the morning, so it's kind of carried over from Saturday night. Social energy, groups of people, communication, but there's a lot of illusional ideas going on here with Venus square Neptune. But trying to find, you know, trying to be satisfied within relationship dynamics or social energy or communication, networking, and yet that trine to Venus leads back to Mercury, which is square Mars, so probably isn't going to be the most nice trine with peace, you know, or diplomacy. But the moon will be in the last degrees of Libra through Sunday, building up the square to Jupiter, Pluto, and Saturn. This is when things get really tough. A block, a restriction, the moon is in a last quarter square to these Capricorn transits, which is having to kind of accept and integrate. And there's a block, there's a restriction, there's limitation here in relationships, there's limitation in circumstances that we just have to accept and deal with. But there could be an emotional struggle with trying to be diplomatic and graceful about these things and trying to be peaceful and create harmony and be fair about it, wanting justice about something here, connected to the government, the world. And yet, there may, you know, circumstances may not be fair. You know, that's the thing with what Libra has had to deal with for a long time with these Capricorn transits, is not everything is fair right now in the way that Libra would like it to be. There isn't exactly the justice that we would like to see. There isn't a sense of equality in our own personal situations, especially if you have a lot of Libra planets. You're going through some of those circumstances that may not feel fair and justified or something. So there's things that we just have to deal with. There's things that are outside of our control. And with the moon square Jupiter, the emotional energy is extra amplified, extra intense with Pluto there. There's extremes. There's shadow here in relationships. And with Pluto, with the square to Pluto, circumstances are kind of being forced to go through a transformation and they don't feel comfortable. It's not easy. It's not what we want. Which leads to the square to Saturn Sunday night, feeling blocked and restricted and limited and held back and having to deal with things that are heavy, pressure and stress. But it's interesting because that leads back to Venus square Neptune, which typically can be a very romantic square and very optimistic and inspired and dreamy and a lot of fantasy. But it's almost like regardless of what fantasy or illusion or trying to be in your own little world of pleasure, whatever that may be, circumstances are still picking up on hardcore reality with the square over to Saturn, and circumstances and the mood is still really intense and powerful. But people aren't looking at this situation realistically in some way because it does lead to Venus square Neptune. And so this really intense energy on Sunday morning, people are just not, they're kind of lost, they're confused. They could be fighting for justice around something that is just kind of an illusion. It may not be grounded in reality. Something like that is possible. And it's still pretty fierce communication energy because that square over to Saturn, Pluto, and all that, it leads to Venus square Neptune, and then Venus is ruled by Mercury square Mars. So again, there's issues on the streets, in communities, strong, aggressive communication, and powerful situations, power and control issues. It's going to be intense Saturday into Sunday. So that block and that restriction, that weight and heaviness continues most of the day on Sunday. The moon does pick up on a trine to the north node. So maybe the circumstances from Saturday into Sunday, they have you on the path and trying to get in touch with where you're going and what your future is. Trying to figure it out. But again, hold off on making very big value judgments or trying to be clear about things when Venus is tightly square Neptune. So try to hold back a little bit. Try to use some patience and caution, and don't just react, because there's going to be a lot of strong reactions without necessarily it being grounded. People fighting for something that may be an illusion. And then the moon will ingress Scorpio. Big change of mood there on late Sunday night. So the moon isn't always easy here. The moon is in fall in Scorpio, so emotions go deep. And now there's this need to be more private with your feelings and your emotions and hold back a little bit, a little deeper. But you always have to be careful with the moon moving through Scorpio not to piss people off, because they're going to hold a grudge. The moon in Scorpio holds on to things really deeply and powerfully and doesn't let go. And so if you create tension with people or you're in a fight, they might not, it could turn out bad. It could be a long lasting type of thing, because the moon is the ruler of Mercury here in Cancer, which is tightly square Mars. So, you know, every month when the moon is in transit through these different signs, it has a little bit of a different effect based on the other planets and where they're at. And now with the moon in Scorpio and its fall ruling Mercury square Mars, that energy gets more fierce, gets more kind of like brooding and holding things deeply within, trying to control. So the power and control dynamic that was sparked up by the Libra moon square Pluto continues into Scorpio, and there's this letting go of trying to find the balance and the harmony and the peace and the diplomacy, and now it's just getting deeper and a little more, you know, like a scorpion wanting to sting. But it's also trying to just be more private about those things and more secretive. And then emotions are more kind of amplified and trying to control it all. It just becomes a little more, you know, challenging with the emotional energy based on what happened on Saturday that continues into Sunday and into Monday. Let's see here. And that leads us to the first quarter moon, actually. So the tension continues, because the moon in Scorpio has to square the sun in Leo, the first quarter moon, out of this new moon cycle that was rooted in Cancer opposite Saturn. So this is the first challenge that this lunar cycle has in getting past something, the first quarter moon, the crisis and the action, how to move forward, how to take action, how to initiate something that we've needed to do here that we're on board with, but there's challenges, there's obstacles, there's block, there's a lack of cooperation here through the weekend and into Monday. And this is the most powerful day, the most interesting day out of this entire forecast, because there's so many different aspects going on here that are super rare to have all at once. So here we go. The first quarter moon, the crisis in action, pushing forward, not retreating. This isn't retreat energy. The moon is building, waxing. Mars is direct in Aries. There's all this cardinal energy. And it's time to be powerful. It's time to step into that confidence of the Leo sun, the leadership, the decisiveness. But the problem is that there's a lot of fluff going on here all at the same time, and it's confusing, it's distracting. There's a lack of clarity, but people might not realize there's a lack of clarity and be certain or set on something because of the sun in Leo and the moon in Scorpio, which is fixed energy. But moon Scorpio square sun in Leo is always one of the most dramatic squares there is. So very dramatic day here on Monday that was carried over from the weekend. And you have to be careful. You have to try to get through some blocks and some obstacles here and find solutions and not back down. But at the same time, be careful and not too aggressive or overly pushy and communicative with other people in an aggressive way, because you're going to see that. This is where, like, you can see that Mercury is tightly square Mars during this first quarter moon. So this is a very dramatic aspect, and technically it's a T-square because Uranus is in the mix. I mean, the day ends with the moon opposite Uranus after we have all kinds of different aspects. So this is when Venus is making the in conjunction to Jupiter. Let me look at that list, because there's so much here. Jupiter sextile Neptune, Venus in conjunct Jupiter, Venus square Neptune, Mercury square Mars, and Moon opposite Uranus. Wow. So it's hard to interpret because it's so dynamic. So the Jupiter coming back into sextile with Neptune, they're both retrograde. It's kind of evaluating beliefs and opinions and faith and culture. Jupiter rules Sagittarius, where the South Node is. So that automatically makes Jupiter at one of its worst placements. When the South Node is in Sag, Jupiter's never going to be at its best. Plus, Jupiter's debilitated and it's conjunct Pluto and Saturn. And so we have to make adjustments, big time adjustments, to our desires, to our fantasies, relationships, based on the past, based on past beliefs of what things should be or what we want them to look like. Opinions are so strong, judgments. We have to make adjustments on relationships or money issues based on the world, what's playing out in the world. But Jupiter, Neptune, it really enhances. I mean, I want to say it's a positive aspect, but when you put it in context with all this other stuff, it doesn't look very positive. It can be a lot of illusions. It could be this collective mindset that's going on out in the world right now with so much. There's just a lot of things that aren't true that people are strongly believing in, and people's idea around truth. There's some challenges in those things. A lot of people are fighting for things that aren't even legit. Not every single thing, don't get me wrong, so don't get all upset with some people. I know they're so sensitive these days, but not everything is truthful, and not everything isn't truthful. I mean, it's hard to know what is and what isn't. That's part of the problem here with Neptune and Jupiter. But the positive side could be being inspired, being hopeful, looking at possibilities of change for the world in the future or your Capricorn area of life in your personal chart. The problem is Venus in this square, it may not be realistic. Your hopes, your idealistic vision of the possibilities and what you want to change, you may have to go through a little bit of a wake-up call or a reality check later on, or disillusionment about some of that stuff. But it's a very amplified, dreamy energy around beliefs and opinions and truth and culture and all these things playing out in the world. Kind of really messy on Monday, to be honest with you. And again, communication is still very agitated and aggressive, and you have to be careful of traveling, transportation, mechanical breakdowns, being too pushy and forceful. A lot of drama here going on. So that's pretty much what I see. And then there's disruptions. There's things that are kind of chaotic. There could also be financial situations here because the moon in Scorpio is connected to resources and finances. And it's picking up on Uranus in Taurus, which the sun is building a square to. And Uranus in Taurus is ruled by Venus square Neptune. So be extra careful around money issues here on Monday, and we could wake up to some sort of a financial or a stock market issue or something like that potentially on Monday. Now, is it positive or negative? I don't know, because it almost feels like there could be an illusion around a possibility of something positive in those regards, but is it positive or is it just an illusion? Or it could be a downright wake-up call and a disappointment, because this is the final square between Neptune and Venus that's been building up, for the last couple months. So it could be a reality check around something of value or resources or money or the stock market or something kind of chaotic here on Monday. Strong potential for that. That's very dramatic in some way. So do your best to not get sucked in to the collective nonsense. And be careful of, if you have personal planets around 4 degrees of the fixed signs, give or take a few degrees there, this will impact you personally, especially if you have your inner planets in those degrees. But if you don't have any planets around these degrees, it might not affect you. It just might be playing out in the collective, and you're seeing the result on the news, the media, stuff like that. And the day is finalized by that moon opposition to Uranus, which again has something disruptive kind of playing out most of the day. And then we get past that, and it looks like Tuesday. There's a lot of trines and sextiles mixed in with in conjunctions, which means as we get into Tuesday, July 28, the moon is in better shape than it was. Mercury has already perfected that square. Venus has already perfected that square. So Monday was like a turning point, and then Tuesday, it's kind of like this trying to work with what just happened through the weekend into Monday. And you know, it's a better day, I think. Things start to calm down a little bit. It's still there, though. It's not going to just instantly change, but it's not as crazy as the following day. And with all the inconjunctions that are taking place at the same time, we have to make a lot of adjustments to what played out through the weekend and into Monday. And things start to stabilize, I think, a little bit in the short term, but the sun is still building the square to Uranus in the following week, so... Now, with all that said, don't get me wrong. I know it sounds crazy and hard and negative out in the world. And if you just look at the world, it is, okay? That's the bottom line. But as I said in the beginning of this report, this is secondary to you. This doesn't necessarily have to directly affect you as a person. Your own personal transits is what is directly affecting you. This might indirectly affect you based on your surroundings, the outer world, what's in your environment, stuff like that. So you have way more control over this general energy out in the world than you do with your own personal transits that you have to deal with regardless. So again, don't let this like bring you down. There's a lot of heavy energy, of course. It's not going away. This is the year of craziness. We just have to accept that and deal with that. And there's goods in between. There's ups and downs on the daily. So it's not all, you know, you can work with it. And the more conscious you are, the more grounded you are, the more aware of these aspects you are, the better you can handle it. And so that's why you can reference this video throughout the week. Look in the description when those exact aspects are coming exact, and then make decisions based on those things. You know, don't try to do something when the moon is square Mercury. Don't try to communicate or get something out and get your point across when the moon is square Mercury, or try to run an errand. You know, or you just have to, you know, this is how we can work with astrology, by giving us an advantage over the general population. And knowing these aspects is the key to that. But again, it's indirectly affecting us, and it doesn't have to be in the way that I'm explaining here. This is playing out in the world, and you can work with it differently the best you can. But also, not everything is rosy, as you know, and we don't have full control over everything in this world. In fact, we have very limited control. We only have control over ourselves and how we react and deal with what is given to us. But we don't have control in the way that we want to have, as far as other people and what's going on in the outer world. And, you know, that's where it's a tricky fine line to find that balance between, you know, accepting what's outside of your control, and then taking appropriate action and controlling what is in your control. It's just a tough thing to figure out. But I have faith you can, and I hope that's a helpful report. It's a long one. So, yeah, I'm thankful for Leo season. Let's get out of that Cancer season. And I wish you all the best with it. Take good care.